What's going on, socialites? This is Now You Know. Now, child, who would have thought that Jesy Nelson leaving Little Mix would bring up a whole slew of issues, which are not just blackfishing, and I bet you some of these things she didn't even see coming. But before we get into all this, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, and make sure that you have your post notifications turned on so you never miss another upload. Now, let's get into this mess, because, child, it's a hot one. So, if you don't know who Little Mix is, they're a girl group who was formed by Kelly Rowland on the British series of The X Factor, but it includes Jade, Pierre, Leigh-Anne, and the last member who left the group back in 2020, Jesy, who's been the center of a lot of conversation. So recently, Jesy actually claimed that she walked away from Little Mix due to her mental health because of things like receiving a lot of hate from fans who would comment on her weight in comparison with her other bandmates. Now, fast forward to a year later, and Sis is out here releasing new music, which includes Nicki Minaj and, in the video, a look from Diddy.
Jeezy, Jesy, Little Mix, whatever y'all calling yourselves these days.
Now, granted, her look overall did change over the past 10 years that she was in the group, but this new look that Sis has social media and her former bandmate Leigh-Anne talking. So in this new song with Nicki Minaj and the cameo from Diddy that's called Boys, despite it being her solo moment, she's been called out for blackfishing. So in the video, Jesy's clearly depicting black culture with things like her hair, her overly hip-hop style baggy clothes, her lips, just a lot of aesthetic that gave off black culture. Now, the other thing that happened to have people calling her a blackfish was actually her skin tone. So as we said, over the past 10 years, her look has changed, but if we look from Jesy back in the day to what she looks like now, there's clearly some things that are different when it comes to her lighter skin tone back then and her new orange darker skin tone now. Now, after this video came out, a TikToker who's actually a self-proclaimed Little Mix superfan hopped on Instagram, dropping a private DM between him and Leigh-Anne, who is still in Little Mix, and that's when things started to go left. So the TikToker, again on Instagram, posted a question asking if he should make a dance to the new song Boys, which again is Jesy and Nicki Minaj's new single. Now, the receipts that are dropping on social media are not looking good, because it's looking as if Leigh-Anne actually responded to that video message saying, "No." He says, "OMG Leigh-Anne, I thought you were okay." To which she says, "Do a video about her being a blackfish instead." And he said, "I'm low-key hurt." Which she responds saying, "She blocked us, cut us off, horrible person." Then he says, "Hold on," of course, because he's a Little Mix fan, and goes further into it saying, "I have never listened to the newspaper or people online about the drama that goes on behind the scenes in the group. I wanted to ask you, but never felt it was my place, as I don't know you very well. I've supported Little Mix since I was 17 years old, and the band and the music has defined my entire adulthood. I'm a diehard Little Mix fan, everyone knows it." Now, Leigh-Anne responded saying, "No one knows anything, you're right not to trust the papers. This time, they were right, lol, it's really sad." To which then he sent a couple different voice messages, and she responded at the end saying, "It's up to you, babe, I'm just raging today." Now, this of course caused so much more drama, because the man who put this out on Instagram actually then hopped on his TikTok page with a message directed at those who were calling the messages fake, and even standing up for Jesy and calling out Leigh-Anne for sending the messages in the first place.
"What I will say is that I don't think that it's very appropriate for a member of Little Mix to message me after I posted a video dancing to the new Jesy Nelson song, saying that, you know, I should make a video about her being a blackfish instead. The way that I look at it is, if you're that concerned, rather than being shady about it and trying to get other people to do your dirty work, why don't you speak out on about it yourself? Like, you know, come on, you've made a documentary. Why don't you speak out? What's this compared to a documentary speaking? Why don't you speak out about it? It doesn't make any sense to me. You won't speak out about it because that would affect your opportunities, your brand deals, your movies, your music, your career. But you don't mind me taking the fall and potentially affecting my opportunities."
But it gets even worse than this. So after all of this went public, Jesy actually hopped on an Instagram Live with Nicki, and that's when things kind of took a turn for the worse in regards to Nicki's statements. She actually came for Leigh-Anne in defense of Jesy, calling out the DMs, which she kept referring to as texts, but this is what Nicki had to say about it.
"Take them text messages and shove it up your because when you do clown sh, I gotta treat you and talk to you like you a clown. Don't have to come out and try to ruin anyone. Let her have her, let her enjoy this time. If you was in this woman's group and you ain't talk about this for 10 years, and as soon as you see she got a video come out with Nicki Minaj and Puffy, now you sending the stations text messages and all this, print them text messages out. Bust your ass open and shove it up your mother."
Now, later on in the live, Jesy actually addressed the situation regarding people calling her out for her new look, both in the video and real life, claiming that she was not intending to hurt anyone's feelings in the black community, and that she just wanted to pay respect to what seems the 90s hip-hop era.
"To celebrate that, like, I just wanted to celebrate that era of music because it's what I love. And yeah, like my intentions, I'm to never, we're never, ever, ever to offend anyone. And genuinely, like it actually does really hurt me that I may have offended people and actually like hurt people's feelings just by genuinely celebrating something that I love.
Now, before we go any further into this, let's pause right here really quickly, because one thing that's interesting is that she claimed that she had no clue that she was doing anything other than her normal life. She even referenced the fact that her father is the reason that she has naturally curly hair, and that once while on vacation with Little Mix, it was actually Leigh-Anne who asked her if she was mixed with black due to the amount of tan that she got while sitting on the beach. However, let's also remember that Leigh-Anne was very vocal about the hate that she was receiving being the only black member of the group.
My reality is feeling anxious before fan events and signings because I always feel like I'm the least favoured. My reality is constantly feeling like I have to work 10 times harder and longer to mark my place in the group because my talent alone isn't enough.
But Leigh-Anne didn't actually stop there. She actually did a documentary called Race, Pop, and Power, where she talks about her personal struggles, again, being the only black person in Little Mix, but also being a black British artist as a whole. Now, back to this Instagram Live. While Jesy was talking about how she didn't mean to offend anybody and claimed she didn't know what the issue was, she also addressed that Leigh-Anne and the other group members did have a conversation with her in regards to her blackfishing, saying this.
With two women of color for 9 years, and it was never brought up to me up until the last music video that I did with them, when she like messaged me and said like, Jesy, I just want to make you aware that like.
So it seems like she's very much aware of how she's been representing herself as a blackfish for quite some time. So Socialites, knowing all of this, what are your thoughts about the whole situation? Let us know in the comment section down below. As always, make sure you like us on Facebook, you're following us on Instagram, and you're subscribed to our YouTube channel, because now you know what's trending.